go through an example. In the last lessons, you may have noticed our examples have been centered around social science, like social networking with the cloud example and your engagement in class. But in this lesson and the next, we'll be using a lot of examples from the fields of biology and medicine, since statistics is heavily used in those fields as well. I drew a finch here, and that's because this next example deals with the beak width of finches. Specifically, scientists have looked at finches to make hypotheses about evolution. By mapping a trait over time, like beak width, we can tell if the environment is selecting for a particular size of beak width. Maybe there's a particular beak size that better helps this finch survive. But sometimes there are random fluctuations in beak width due to variation in the population. Some finches just have bigger beak widths than others. Therefore, to determine whether there is a significant change in beak width within the population over time, we need to use statistics. If the mean beak width does significantly increase or decrease in size, this is referred to as directional selection. Then the environment allows the survival and reproduction of finches with bigger beak widths. Let's say we know that the average beak width of all finches is 6.07 millimeters. This includes finches that have been studied over the last few years. But now let's say we're studying a sample of finches from today. We want to know, do finches today have beak widths that are different in size? That means our null hypothesis is that the population mean for finches today is equal to what they have been. And what should the alternative hypothesis be? That mu is less than 6.07, greater than 6.07, or not equal to 6.07.